Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and it is Tuesday, which means we'll tackle some creative filmmaking techniques. Many of you guys were asking for an After Effects tutorial. We promised it would come, so here we are. We're going to recreate the ink drop effects from the intro, and it's actually very simple with the help of Sumi, a video pack from Rocketstock. They're sponsoring today's episode, and we're also so kind to share several samples from this pack for free. You can find a download link to it in the description below so that everyone can follow along. And to learn more about the actual pack itself, you can visit the first link in the description. The first thing I did was create a rough storyboard with the elements from Sumi. I chose which ink drops I was going to work with and put them in a timeline. That way I could give directions to the dancer and make her movements match with the flow of the ink drops. After that, I brought all my shots together with the clips from Sumi into After Effects. And the first thing I did was setting up the blending. So I took one shot from the dancer and one clip from the Sumi pack. The ink drop layer goes on top of your clip. We're going to use the track mat now. And if you can't see it, right-click anywhere in your columns, say columns, and enable the modes. You will now see the column track mat, and for that clip of the dancer, we'll choose Luma Inverted Mat. And that will disable the ink drop layer and solely use it as a mat for our clip. We're blending her in with the dark ink. If you would like to use a white ink clip on a black background, you have to choose the Luma Mat from the track mat drop-down box and not the inverted one. This track mat option is something that is used very often, and you'll find that out yourself once you're going to create more inside After Effects. The next technique will create a lot more dynamic to the overall edit. All of your ink drops were shot in slow motion, and we can use that to our advantage. Right-click on the ink drop layer, head over to Time, and say Enable Time Remapping. A new property in your layer will appear with a first keyframe. That keyframe represents the current time of that clip at that point. If you would play a little further, where the ink drop is completely revealed, and create a new keyframe, nothing will happen. This keyframe represents again the normal time at that point. But now comes the cool thing. We can move these two keyframes close to each other. Now it takes less time for that clip to go from point A to B. In other words, we've speeded up the first part of the ink drop. And because we're working with keyframes, we can right-click on the last one, go to Keyframe Assistant, and say Easy Ease In. This way the ink drop is fast forwarded, but it will fade slowly back to real time. This looks a lot better, more refined. You can even take more control over this. If you would select that last keyframe and click on the button Graph Editor, you'll actually see the curve of how the speed slowly goes back to real time. You can even pull its lever to change that curve and make the speed transition even smoother. By the way, if you can't see that lever, click on the Graph Type button at the bottom and make sure Edit Speed Graph is selected. I'm doing the same thing with the clip of the dancer, which was also shot in slow motion. And those who wondered, it was all shot in 4K resolution at 60 frames per second on the GH5. When I had my second ink drop coming in, I wanted the first one to dissolve. You can see that also here, the clip in solo. Now, there are two things that I've done. First of all, the same time remapping technique. This to speed up the clip as the second one comes in. That way it looks like the second ink drop pushes the first one away. I wanted the dancer to dissolve with the ink, so from my effects library I searched for Turbulent Displace and dragged that to the clip from the dancer. Move your playhead to where the speed up of the ink starts and create a keyframe for the amount of the Turbulent Displace effect. Make sure your first value is set to 0 though. Then move a little further in time and increase that value. The results already look great, but as a final touch it will also add a Gaussian blur to it. Also here, I'm creating keyframes to increase the Gaussian blur as the turbulent displace increases as well. As the final touches, you can give a nice color grading to your clips or even play with different blending modes from the drop-down menu at your clip's layer. This works great if you're working on a textured background like this paper. But you can also use one of the ink drops as a background. The pack comes with some watercolor paper drops that goes great together. If you want to invert the black and white, you can simply drag the invert effect from your library to it. I want to thank Els so much for her great performance and Rocketstock for this pack. To find out more, you can visit the first link in the description below, guys. And of course, the most important thanks goes to you guys for watching again. Stay creative.